Alright. Folks, I'm jumping back into Espresso Tycoon.
After a successful internship in Cape Town, you have received a plane ticket to the bustling city of New York.
Ooh. Lapatiti Café.
Hello again. How was your flight from Cape Town? I hope you handle 22-hour flights better than I do. Anyway, here we are in New York. They say the city never sleeps, so it seems like a perfect place for another coffee shop. This place has potential, but we'll have to work on it, starting, of course, with the brand. A recognizable brand is a must-have in such a competitive market. Now let's take care of the coffee shop itself. At this moment, it's very neglected, but I'm sure you can quickly bring this place back to life. Do you see this cabinet in the middle? The previous owner must have left it here. Let's sell it to make some space. As you can see, not only did we get more space, but we also got some extra cash. Remember, if you ever need some money, you can always sell some of your furniture. Anyway, it's time to renovate the walls and floors. Change. Now the coffee shop looks awesome. It reminds me of some popular TV show from the 90s. What was its name? I can't remember. Anyway, let's keep on working. It would be a waste to have such a cozy space and not add some tables and chairs. Let's do it now.
Okay, 3 tables, 3 chairs. come back to the chairs.
You are a natural-born interior designer. Now that our cafe isn't so empty anymore, we have to hire a barista. Since our place isn't very popular yet, I saw only one CV sent by. Let me check. Rachel Bean. Well, let's hire her. Rachel Bean! That reminds me of someone. She is now part of your business, but she has no clue when she should start her shift. So let's set up her schedule. Remember, each employee prefers different working hours.
Okay.
You successfully assigned her the hours. Now let's wait till she starts her shift. Remember, when there's no barista in the coffee shop, you can always skip time until the next one shows up. Great! We're almost done setting up the coffee shop. I've already organized some supplies, such as coffee beans, water filters, takeaway cups, and milk. However, we've been using cheap, low-quality supplies so far, and it's time to level up. Let's prioritize getting better coffee beans from a reliable provider.
Open the supply window. Dream away.
Now that you know how to use different supply providers, it's time to open your coffee shop. But did we forget something? Of course. We forgot to set the menu and prices. Let's do that now. Now we are truly ready. Let's open the coffee shop. It's officially open. Now it's just a matter of time until it will be full of customers. Do you see this elderly gentleman? Let's see who he is. This is Tom Heckles, a senior. He's about to buy a coffee. As you can see, Tom appreciates the fact. Notice how the money you earn from selling that coffee multiplies. Money multiplier is a secret ingredient of our world. You earn more when your cafe looks nicer. Each decoration item gives you some style points, and when you get enough of them, your money multiplier increases. Let's do it now.
Okay,
You have a hint on how to earn money faster. Thanks to that, you will be able to invest more money to grow your business. For example, by training your employees. Try to train Rachel in any skill now. Once Rachel's training is done, her skill will improve. It's important because your customers... You may wonder why you even need a guitar and amplifier. Well...
How rude. Mission. Almost, almost. Cool.
From the city that never sleeps to the land of samba and caipirinhas. Starting a coffee shop in a crowded metro station? Good luck keeping up with the busy commuters, but hey, if you can make it in Sao Paulo, you can make it anywhere. After surviving the morning rush hour first.
Still 10 coffees. Have 8 plants. And a barista with a skill coffee on minimum level. Good. Okay.
Nice to see you again. This time at the metro station in Sao Paulo. I'm so excited. I have never seen a coffee shop placed 8 floors below the ground level. Although there's not much competition in this particular location, as always, we must start by creating a brand.
Okay. We'll go back to this. This one.
Every time I see so many people, I wonder who they are and what they do in life. For example, this lady over there. Can you see her? Let's find out who she is.
What lady? Oh, her. Okay.
A businesswoman. I've seen many white collars around. I think right above us there is a business center. As you can see, our menu doesn't contain any coffee she'd like. So far, we've been working with only basic coffee recipes, but from now on, we're equipped with a powerful tool. Coffee Editor! It lets us not only compose custom recipes, but also check out if different social groups like them. Let's sew a tailor-made suit. I mean coffee. For businessmen.
Okay. I don't know, man. I'm trying to come up with a damn name for this. It's a coffee? Espresso. Cold brew. More espresso. Moist really gonna make it. More cold brew. Steamed milk. Now we'll go with vanilla ice cream. Okay, nope. Okay, like raspberry syrup. Okay. Okay. I like the cold. Oh. Okay. Oh, they're like extra large. Okay, they also like high caffeine. Awesome, that's very sure. Visitor. Perfect.
Great. Now boosted with your coffee, they can take care of their business even faster. By the way, sometimes you may wonder how different social groups react to your entire coffee repertoire. You can always check that in the customers window, specifically in the preferences tab. Check it out now. Nice overview, right? Cool. Ideally, every social group should be colored green, which means you offer something they really like. If it's yellow, they may order something from time to time. If it's red, they will never order anything. By the way, our current coffee machine is decent, but we should invest in a newer model. Let's upgrade it now. With this coffee machine, the taste and preparation time of your coffee will be improved. But that's not all. This model also contains a milk frother. It means you'll be able to prepare coffees with steamed milk or milk foam and decorate them with latte art. Let's make use of it.
Okay. Espresso. What the seniors like? Okay. Oh, wait. They got ice cubes. It's all very high calories, huh? I also want a little colder. We'll take them out. Okay, they like it cold. Okay. 10 to 29. They went cold. So, a little bit of ice cubes. I don't care about the caffeine. Wonder to that's perfect. Cool.
Great. Many customers will appreciate such a beautiful drawing on their coffee. When creating latte art, you can always use one of the popular templates, but surprise! You can also create your own drawing. Try it now.
You think I'm gonna pain in my ass? Okay. Okay, they do like ice cream. Okay, caffeine even to 100. Calories they don't want. Huh.
Latte art is my favorite kind of art. Since we improved the coffee repertoire a bit, let's focus on the style of this place a bit. We're underground, so every plant brings some freshness to this place. However, you need to water them. Otherwise, they will wilt. I actually saw some dry plants here. Let's bring them back to life. Green plants. From now on.
Yeah, okay.
As you may have noticed, for safety reasons, we celebrated the opening with confetti, not fireworks this time. Well, that's it.
Yeah, okay. I don't have employees yet.
No.
Schedule. Is she 8 hour day, which doesn't say when. Hey, here we go, skipping time. But wait a minute. Oh. Where's my tables or chairs this shit at?
Thank you.
Okay. Gotta find plants. And I think after this,
hey.
Hey.
Oh, okay. What did she prefer when I hired her? I didn't see it. She likes 8 hour days, huh? Oh, she prefers afternoons. Okay. Prefers nights. Supplies. I can't remember.
Hey.
And on that note, folks, I am calling this episode here, because it's almost an hour, so I will check you guys out later.